You're a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate deck.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. One day after I released my tier list for the month, Konami decided to put out a ban list for the game, so that is very convenient. The balance has shifted and we have some really interesting limitations, not only nerfs to skills, but also we have limited to 1 cards, limited to 2 and also to 3. The new addition to the ban list is gonna be really important for the future of the metagame. This will be my first reactions to the list, by the way, I have not looked at it before, this is the first time, and the list is going to take action on May 21st, which is, I believe, next Thursday. Let's see what has changed with the skills first. Now I immediately see grid here. Okay, so it now limits you to 1 special summon after the turn you used it to save you, essentially. And I think this is an okay nerf, but at the same time, decks like Masked Heroes that used the skill, if one of your goals with the skill was to avoid the OTK because of grit and the next turn try to OTK your opponent yourself without being able to special summon multiple Ankis in one turn, I do not think you're gonna be able to do that, so maybe a deck like Masked Heroes now needs to drift away from grit. It is not a skill ending nerf, but at the same time, as we progress in duelings, it's gonna be special summon city. So I don't believe it is a great nerf. Next, I see baggy sleeves, thunder dragons, my first thought immediately. So let's see what changed here. Okay, yeah. A level 7 or higher monster now needs to be destroyed and is also once per duel. Which does make sense. Thunder dragons had immense drawing power. Now the skill is more fair. And nerfing the skill immediately doesn't make the deck obsolete, which is good. I believe that is a good nerf. No mortal can resist is here. Okay, back-to-back Isizu skills in back-to-back ban lists. And sealed tombs has not been used a lot after the nerf. Let's see what did they do to no mortal can resist. Once per duel can only be used when your life points are at least 2000 less than your opponent. Okay, so it's a trend, I guess, to make Isizu's graveyard skills be more like comeback skills, but I don't like that nerf really. I wasn't a fan of the Sealed Tombs nerf either, and I'm still not a fan of it. I don't really like that, I guess I get it though, because every graveyard strategy gets countered by Isizu's skills. Probably they're not gonna be the most famous skills now in the second stages of the case cup after the nerfs, but I guess we have to wait and see. Transcendent Crystals? Okay, so Crystrons also get nerfed. It can only be used from turn 3 onwards now. Okay, that is interesting. That is not ending the skill by any means. Makes Crystrons maybe less explosive, maybe a bit slower, but I don't really like the nerf, not because of the Crystron nerf, that is fine, but mainly because Transcendent Crystals was never aimed to be a Crystron's skill or any other deck skill other than Crystal Beasts, right? So you nerf Crystal Beasts as well, and there's no point for that nerf. So I don't like that because Crystal Beast decks, I know they're not meta or anything, but maybe someone that was playing Crystal Beasts for fun with Jesse now has a nerfed skill out of nowhere because of Crystrons. In my opinion, it would be best to nerf the skill specifically for Crystrons and not in general. For example, make the skill say that it can only be used, but you need to have in your deck like 4 different Crystal Beast monsters or something. Make it specific to Crystal Beasts, that would be a way better nerf. And then Crystrons could not even use the skill anymore, but I guess maybe they wanted to keep it a bit relevant for the deck still. Then we have Fusion Time. It has now 1000 life points cost and not 1500, but it's once per duel, not once per turn. Okay, so that's a buff nerf and a nerf buff at the same time. Okay, I guess. And then Deck Master Effect, Cyber Commander. Cyber Commander is buffed. We have been saved. New meta, May 2020. It's here to dominate. All right. So nothing much is buffed as far as skills, but we have some pretty interesting nerfs. I really am curious to see what the card nerfs look like. So let's jump straight to that. I'm really interested to see what they're gonna do with the limited to 3 part of the ban list, if they have new additions there at least. So let's start with limited 1 though. The synchro. Okay, that's a weird start. We're limiting this card as using multiple copies of this card and repeatedly special summoning for Lady Water enabled players to draw many times. Okay, so a loop was there that Konami was not intended for it to happen, so that's why the synchro is limited 1. It does make sense because it's a strategy they did not want in the game, and the synchro is not a meta card anyway. I get it. So Cyberstein is here. Okay, now that is weird, because they should have done that like a year ago. They decide to do it now. We're limiting this card as it allowed players to consistently end duels without giving their opponent a chance to fight back by special summoning several powerful fusion monsters within a turn. Yeah, aka Ojama King. They summon it and you're pretty much finished. So I'm glad this is limited to 1, but I'm not sure why they did it now. Maybe something's gonna come out that would help Cyberstein be more consistent or something, I don't know, but I'm not opposed to it. It's a fine limit by me. Next we have Element Saber Mallow. Alright, now we move on to the meta. Decks that use this card have had consistently a high winning percentage over the course of many months. Therefore, we are limiting this card to prevent the metagame becoming stale. Yeah, classic reasoning by Konami. Pretty much invest in something new. Now, Element Sabers have been indeed relevant for a long time. I think maybe 6 months, maybe more than that. I don't know, but they have been relevant for a long time and they have been top of the tier list for a long time as well. Cocytus is also limited to 1, so they class those two. Okay, that is really interesting. So this is a big nerf. You can't play Mallow anymore, pretty much, if it is an Element Saber Invoked hybrid deck. That's gonna be interesting. I think that Element Sabers Invoked maybe are gonna start to be played less and less. Konami is trying to get them out of the top tiers though, that is for sure. Next card is limited to 2 now, okay. Magician of Dark Illusion, okay. So they do touch Dark Magician in the most like soft way possible, that is. This is limited to 2 straight up, so Dark Magician cannot run Enemy Controller and Treacherous Trap Hole if they want to run Magician of Dark Illusion. And that's, yeah, that is pretty much the reasoning as well, and it does make sense. That is a fair nerf, absolutely correct nerf to Magician of Dark Illusion. Then, whoa, Vision Hero Vion is back on the ban list. And it's pretty much for the same reason as Magician of Dark Illusion, and it is also fair. Because let's be honest, Vion, first of all, not needed at 3 anyway. Second of all, masked heroes and heroes in general, especially after Stratos is out, are gonna be way too powerful to also be running Treacherous Trap Hole, Hate Runade, and Enemy Controller. So that is a fair nerf. Crystron Rion. Okay, so Crystrons don't only get a skill nerf. Decks that use this card have had a consistently high winning... Okay, so it's the same thing as Element Saber Invoked. Crystrons also have been out for a long time, but they have never been as good as Element Sabers Invoked, and they are flying under the radar of ban lists for a long time now. They did not really deserve a nerf, to be fair, but I understand why Konami does this. The only thing is, you cannot run Enemy Controller now, which is also fair. The Transcendent Crystals nerf might be more impactful to them than this one. Next card is a limited to 3, and it is a Thunder Dragon card. Thunder Dragon Dark. Okay, this card will be limited along with Gold Sarcophagus. Gold Sarcophagus is also here. Yes, it is also here. Okay. So they have an aim at Thunder Dragons for sure in this ban list. First, Baggy Sleeves, Dragon Dark, and now also Gold Sarcophagus, which is an EX and selection box card, and it's really interesting that we see it here. That doesn't destroy Thunder Dragons by any means, but it does make them less explosive, and I think that is what Konami is actually trying to do, because Thunder Dragons do have a lot of success lately, and they did also have success in the second stage of the Case Cup. Maybe they saw that and they're like, we need to at least limit their explosiveness a bit. Then we have Siranui Squire. Okay, so Siranui also get affected by the Gold Sarcophagus nerf, but at the same time, this is not as important for Siranui as it is for Thunder Dragons, because Siranui can really do well without Sarcophagus. Thunder Dragons need it more, if that makes sense. Cosmic Cyclone is also limited to 3, so if you run Siranui, you're gonna play 2 Squire at least, for sure, and 1 Cyclone, or you're gonna totally cut Cosmic Cyclone and play something else. I think Squire is extremely important to the deck, not I think, it is extremely important to the deck, and you're not gonna cut it to 1 by no means. Maybe not even to 2. I think 3 Squire is a pretty important part, so maybe Cosmic Cyclone now is out of the question for Siranui. As someone who plays Siranui, I don't have a problem with that. I can understand that the deck has been relevant and top tier for a long time, and that is a really fair nerf, in my opinion. So let's continue. Whoa! Charge of the Light Brigade is also here. This card will be added to the limited 3 list as it is widely used in decks that utilize graveyard cards. Wow, so they are nerfing Thunder Dragons. They're not joking around. I don't know what they did to Konami, but Levianir is not even out yet. Like officially out, not in a selection box. That's crazy. They play 2-3 Dragon Dark, 2-3 Sarcophagus, and like 3 Charge of the Light Brigade, and everything is limited to 3. Not limited to 2 and limited to 1, so you can, you know, still play 2 Brigade but lose access to some other cards, and then Sarcophagus and Dragon Dark to 3 maybe. The main explanation I can find to this is that they saw how Thunder Dragons performed in the second stage of the Case Cup, the last Case Cup in April, and they also are watching the Thunder Dragon decks dominate ranked, or maybe the ones existing at least, because the deck is not that extremely popular since Levianir is not officially out. And they are like, when we do actually officially get Levianir in a box, this deck will be out of control. So let's nerf it to shreds right now, probably. Or maybe they'll get new support in the Levianir box, I don't know. No more Thunder Dragon stuff, we're in the clear. In conclusion, Thunder Dragons got it the worst by far, 100%. Then Element Saber Invoked will probably start to see less play. Siranui are relatively fine compared to the other tier 1 decks, but at the same time they will need to adjust since Squire now clashes with Cosmic Cyclone and also Gold Sarcophagus. And other than that, oh yeah, No Mortal Can Resist, also a pretty important nerf. Crystrons are completely fine. I do not like the Transcendent Crystals nerf. Dark Magician is completely fine. Same goes with Masked Heroes, Cyberstein, and the Synchro, just some degenerate strategies that needed to be limited from Konami, I guess. And I think that's pretty much it. These are my thoughts for the ban list. Do not forget to leave your opinions in the comments down below. I'm really interested to read them. Leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more Duel Links videos. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe. See you in the next one.